This is Laura Tucker Kosh, co-owner of Agent Operations, where we help real estate professionals just like you. We believe that when you focus on your strengths and outsource everything else, there's nothing you can't do. We've got a great show today, so let's get started. Hey guys, it's Laura Kosh with Agent Operations and coming to you as part of a new podcast that we're doing. And we're hoping to just add a tremendous amount of value to this podcast. I know myself, I love listening to podcasts and learning things about the industry and just staying up on trends and just learning. And so it just made so much sense to me for us at Agent Operations to start that podcast journey, because I feel like there's a lot that we want to share and we always are seeking to add value to your experience with us. So hopefully we can share some great nuggets of information. And I know that our listeners and subscribers are also going to be teaching us a bunch of stuff too. So just learning together, and we love your comments, your thoughts, your engagement. And so if there's topics that you want to hear about or people that you want us to interview, I want you to feel empowered to drop us a line, comment in the comments, give us a call and just let us know who you want to hear or what topics you want to hear about. Now, today's topic, we're going to talk about some things, an interesting dynamic that I've seen recently. And it's also something that we ascribe to. It has to do with content marketing. And content marketing is essentially adding value to your customers or potential customers' experience with you. And as a real estate agent, for you, that might mean giving them a little bit of wisdom for their journey, whether they're buying their first-time home buyer, or whether they're a real estate investor who's looking to find out how to not pay a whole lot of money to buy their first investment property. You have all this knowledge in your brain as a real estate agent, real estate professional. And so content marketing would have to do with you sharing that information, whether it's through blog posts, through videos, through podcasts, through free downloads on your website where you build your subscriber database. It's a lot of the stuff that, if you've ever listened to Gary Vee, he really, really pushes this. And I think it's just awesome. If you haven't read his book, The Thank You Economy, you've got to do so. It talks a lot about adding value. And I just think that that's something that's so important. So what we've been working on recently is doing a lot more video and a lot more valuable information just to push out on our channels. And so In thinking about how our customers, our real estate agents that use us, might be able to do that on their own or do that as part of their marketing toolkit, there's a lot of cool things that we can share about how we got up and running on doing more content. And I think one of the first things that I did is I really started listening to some of the great publishers on YouTube, whether it's Gary Vee, Sunny. There's all these different people who really made an impact. And as I was gathering my thoughts on how to do these videos or high-value information podcasts, things like that, I really paid attention to the structure of their videos, how it was presented, if there was an intro, if there was an outro, calls to action, because those are all things in the marketing world that are extremely important. And so put together a kind of a rough roadmap on how to put together an intro and an outro, what things that it should include. And we're going to just talk briefly about those things today. Now, the first thing that I would say is you've got to have music. And this is just from my own perspective. I love having like background music. So you notice the intro and then you'll notice the outro. It has music. And I just think I'm really geeky like that. But it does kind of like it stylizes the piece just a little bit. And so You can do royalty-free music. There's a lot of royalty-free music out there. You can also buy it on, I believe it's ThemeForest, and that's where I purchased ours. And there's just a lot of different types of music. And as a marketing nerd, I just like fell into that hole of listening to what music I should be putting. Because you want to select a music track that is going to represent you, your brand, but also one that is just kind of fits the tone of your style, you know, and fits the tone of your information even that you're going to be sharing. So that's step one. I found out, you know, okay, I selected what music track I was going to use. And then you want to come together, or you want to put together a tagline, something memorable. For agent operations, it's focus on your strengths, outsource everything else. And I think that really encapsulates what we do for people. And so what you'll want to do as you're considering all this is sit down and kind of think through what's the difference you bring to your clients, to your buyers and sellers and property investors. What is it? What is the point of distinction that you deliver for them? And hash it out. And you know what? You don't have to get it perfect the first time. Ours came from an iteration of many, many more words than it ended up being. It ended up being 6 words, but it started at about a paragraph because I like to be wordy sometimes. But you can refine it and hone it and really narrow it down into that phrase that really captures what you do for people. Now, one thing that you can do to offset costs in your video production or podcast or things like that is you can go out and you can get sponsors. And so one of the things that I tell people is, you know, you can go get a sponsor. Maybe it's a mortgage lender who wants to also be in front of your podcast or audience, subscriber audience, and you can do a brought to you by section. Or maybe it's a local business that feels that their target market is really similar or the same as yours, and they're willing to, you know, pay you $150 to appear on your podcast, or $20, or whatever that looks like for you. It just gets you some goodwill, and it also kind of it extends your credibility even, because there's this other business who is kind of partnering with you or purchasing an ad spot, so to speak, on your podcast or video. So check that out. Try that out. Teaser about something at the end of the video. So what do you want people to do? You want people to listen all the way through your content, right? You don't want them turning it off midway through and miss the great nuggets that you've put in at the end. So be sure to kind of build up like almost like a crescendo where you were sharing more and more valuable information. But also at the beginning, give them a little teaser of what their life looks like after listening to your video. So something that's super compelling that they go, oh, that's their aha moment. And paint that picture of what their life's going to be like after they listen to your video. What challenge are they going to overcome? What problem are they going to solve? What is life going to look like? And I think that's really powerful in getting people to not only see the value in your content, but also listen the whole way through and hopefully subscribe to your channel or to your podcast. Now, then you're going to want to make sure it's a meaty video or a meaty topic. It doesn't have to be complex, but it's got to have really good information in order for your listeners to come back again and again. And you do want to perhaps this is my own bias speaking, but you don't want to take yourself too seriously. Like, you want to be real. You really want to kind of, don't be stuffy, just kind of talk like you're talking across from me or your friend or your family member, and just kind of conversational, and don't be too stiff. So, and that not only goes for the feeling in the video or the podcast, but also how you frame it with the comments, the title, the description. When you go and put it on YouTube or launch your podcast and you know, send it out to everybody, you really want it to the description to grab people. So not being stuffy is hugely important. You also want to make sure that your grammar is correct. So there's a tool that we use all the time and has truly revolutionized my writing life. It's called Grammarly, and it just does a great job, and it really improves your writing over the time that you use it. It doesn't just catch errors way more than spell check does, but it actually catches things that are grammatically incorrect and suggests things to you. Hey, you know, this should be, you should use this word instead of this one, or rewrite this sentence. It's kind of cool, and it's really, really easy to use and seamless. So check out Grammarly. One of the things that's super important that I mentioned at the beginning of this piece is that you want to have a call to action, and it has to be a really kind of meaningful call to action as well, where, you know, maybe for us, it's save 10% off your next order if you mention the ad code, blah, 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 you know. And so you want something that's going to be compelling. And maybe as a real estate agent, maybe it's, you know, request, you know, book your listing appointment today to learn more about what your home could be worth in this spring. And so there's things like that, those meaty calls to action. Or if you are relocating to the Austin area, contact me today to set up a personalized tour of the area or neighborhoods. Something that's going to really bring value to that particular individual that you're targeting. Now, there's a couple of things that you want to do too with the intro. You want it to have a little bit about who you are. It has to be super short, as far as you can't go into a long monologue about who you are, but say who you are, say who you're with, say your tagline, and, you know, say brought to you by if you have a sponsor. And then you're going to tease them with something that's really great at the end of the video to get them to listen to the whole thing. Then you're going to get to the meat of the video. And then you're going to do the call to action. And then last but not least, that's when you put together an outro that also reminds people to share your content on social media. So it's got another call to action of sharing on social or subscribing and hitting that red notification button so they get notified of your new YouTube videos. Or maybe it's, hey, leave me a comment if this video helped you. And so what you're asking the user to do is not just simply consume the content and just listen to it, but interact in it. With it, engage with you. And just like we say when we talk to our clients about the importance of sphere of influence marketing, we say that through all of your marketing efforts, you should be helping your peeps, your sphere of influence, to engage with you when it doesn't always have to be about real estate. You're just getting them in the habit of engaging with you, because people are doing a buy and sell cycle 5, sometimes 7 years. You want to keep the people who aren't in that buy sell cycle engaged with you. So you want them to engage with you on off-peak times. So you're, during that time, you're adding value, you're asking them to share on social media about you, or share your content, or listen to your content, or I hope my content helps you. So there's all these little tiny dynamics that go into producing these video or audio pieces of content that will add value to your audience's experience with you. You know, and just to kind of bring it home, some spitball examples I would say are cover different neighborhoods in your area. So for instance, we are just north of Austin in a town called Round Rock. If I were selling real estate in Round Rock, what I would probably do is go to each of the communities or neighborhoods in Round Rock, put together a brief piece about them, and either film on site with my camera or with my phone, or just do an audio, a podcast recording, just telling people what it's about. You know, what is that neighborhood like? What schools are zoned for it? What's the feeling? What's the walkability factor? Are the grocery stores close? What are the entertainment options? What about shopping? All these different things that as a homeowner who's going to be purchasing, or someone relocating from another area, all these things are going to want to know. And so you do that, you put that together, but you don't stop there. You produce your video or your podcast piece, but then you take that information and you put it on your blog. You write a blog post about that neighborhood. And then you take that blog post and you adapt it for a website page. So a page within your website then gets that content. And you can see gradually how you're repurposing this really great piece of information to go throughout your marketing. Next, it might be a social media post or a post on LinkedIn or things like that. So always be thinking about what's the best content that I can do right now? What can I produce? And then how can I repurpose that on other platforms to really get all the mileage? And that's really what Gary Vee is talking a lot about, is splitting the content and adapting it for all the different platforms that you'll be pushing it out on, because your website, you're going to do it differently from your blog, your social media is going to be different from your website. I mean, so there's all these different things that you think about, but if you do a really great piece of information, and then so start there and then figure out how you can repurpose it. So those neighborhood features are super useful for potential clients who are relocating. And then maybe you do a spin on it. And if you're trying to get listings in that neighborhood, you show your authority on that neighborhood. Maybe it's an update on days on market and percentage over or under list price that things are selling. All these different things to show expertise. Maybe you show which homes you sold in the neighborhood, or you talk through that stuff. Really helps you position yourself as the expert in that area. And that's a compelling reason for them to select you as their agent. So just some thoughts and some ideas as we go through. Content thoughts, some things that I thought were pretty powerful. Man, we're getting a lot of meat into this podcast. You want to envision your ideal client. And then from there, you want to create content that helps them solve their biggest challenges. And that's kind of what we just walked through, right? So the biggest challenge for a relocation client is going to be understanding where they want to land, where they want to be. And so by you going out and talking about these neighborhoods and what they offer and what they're like and their feel, you know, what they feel like, that's really going to help them solve their biggest problems. So that dovetails kind of into that. Now, you want to also ask your listeners or your viewers to engage with you. It's not just kind of and we talked about this a little bit ago, but it's not going to be just something where they sit and watch. It's got to be engaging or you're going to lose them. And so some really cool and creative promos that I thought about are, hey, screenshot this episode if you're doing a video. Screenshot this episode and share and tag me in it on social media. I love to see your posts about what we're talking about. I thought that was so creative. And then you could also do, hey, screenshot the work we've done together and share or tag me on social media. And maybe it's, hey, you know, tag me as you're at the closing table, maybe, and you feel comfortable sharing with your friends on Facebook or Instagram, wherever that may be. Hey, tag me and I'll share it with my network if you're comfortable. So a lot of people are probably doing that already, but I think that that's something that really kind of engages your sphere of influence without them having to always be in the buy-sell cycle, but it also capitalizes on the ones who are and celebrates them and celebrates that experience and really it naturally positions you in a great light because of the joy that people are going to see on their faces and just that you helping them through this new chapter in life. So lots of information. Really, these thoughts kind of help you prepare for or even consider, help you consider doing like a podcast or a video series or starting a YouTube channel, because these are really powerful ways that you can reach your customers. And the best thing and probably the most important thing is that you are you're there to give great information to them, whether you're working with sellers or tenants or real estate investors or buyers or relocation buyers. Whatever you can do to really add value to their experience is going to win over. Real estate's about relationships. And so through this content marketing strategy, you can really think about everything from your consumer's perspective. And that's where all that marketing goodness is. And it's not a sale. It's not salesy. It's just presenting great information. So if you thought this was helpful, it was probably a lot of information, and just know that I'm also going to repurpose it. So there'll be a written form for this if you need it later. And just let me know how I did. This is kind of the first podcast episode. Well, it is the first podcast episode. So I just want to know, you know, how I did. And so screenshot or take a picture of yourself and just tag me on social media if you thought this was a cool podcast. But we're going to come at you with a lot of really great information, marketing ideas, ways to save money, ways to repurpose, ways to be a powerful local expert in your own right and in your town, wherever you are, if you're in Texas or not. Anyways, I'll sign off for now, but just thanks for joining us. Have a great day. Thanks for listening. Hey, we love your comments too. If we've helped you, be sure to screenshot and tag us on social media at Agent Operations. You can also join our community by subscribing to updates at agentoperations.net/subscribe, or just click that little red subscribe button on YouTube. This is Laura Tucker Kosh, co-owner of Agent Operations, where we help real estate professionals just like you focus on your strengths and outsource everything else. Faith, passion, purpose. Until next time, friends.